Yeah.
I was talking to Ian downstairs in the bathroom, and we were talking about, like, past season. He just kind of loves reminiscing about, like, the details of past seasons and whatever. Mm-hmm. He mentioned something, and I was like, I'm like, I totally agree. And it was about how I think a lot of us have this perception where we want to take this idea of that we believe in and project it out to the world. This is our platform, right?
Mm-hmm.
And in doing so, I was telling him, like, the biggest impact that took place from Big Brother was on me. I grew the most.
Mm-hmm.
And it was so unexpected.
Mm-hmm.
You know? And I was like, so part of the reason why I came back this time around was because I was like, and this was about, like, being able to kind of figure out a gradient of winning.
Mm-hmm.
If I tell myself winning is just, like, getting the 500K, then there's a whole lot of losing from there.
They love those.
What the fuck?
Yeah. That's why I was kind of shocked. I knew we kind of had the same, you know, when some people kind of have the same character?
Yeah.
So I was like,
to see both of you on here.
Yeah. I thought that was, like,
oh, good. Paul.
You know, like, the quirky.
Yeah.
Awkward, kind of.
I think.
That's the girl I was, anyways. I've grown now and stuff, but, you know, it's, feel like I'm, it's harder already because I'm just like, I don't know.
All right. I like you, Nicole. We can watch you. I don't want to, like... Okay, so they did change the camera. Okay, all right. I'm talking about something spicy. Why you interrupt the... Why you switch the camera, dude? Like, what if it was a very good conversation, you know? Like, I don't fucking know, man. I don't think this is going to be a good conversation. I mean, it might be. I don't fucking know. But I think what K-Star was talking about was fucking awesome.
You look so much like a girl that we had on the season before, season 8. Danny.
Oh.
Everybody compares us. Yeah.
Yeah, with the blonde hair, I can totally.
If you look at the pictures in that photo room, like, there's one of you and one of her, and you guys look. I couldn't tell you guys apart.
Definitely.
Like,
there was a wholesome conversation going on with K-Star and Devon, and it just, you know, interrupted it. So I'm gonna go back and I'm gonna watch it, dude, and we're gonna fucking watch it. I think Devon's ass is in this, so I might switch it out because that's not what the... You know, I'm not... Who the fuck is in control of these cameras, bro? Why is there two? Only two cameras. But it says four.
Like, you know, stuttering, can't really speak English, uncivilized, you know, dangerous.
Okay, it's not popping out. It's fine. I'm not going to get,
you know, respect them.
You know, flagged because of it. So we're good.
And that's not me. So, and I didn't want to be the poster child for all, the, you know, people like that. But
yeah.
I was like, maybe if, like, one person just saw me, like, it would be okay.
For me.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then, fast forward now, it's like, it's almost you feel like, damn, the world is crazy.
Yeah.
And people have lost their damn minds.
I know, yummy.
So, I was like...
I didn't shower yet, so I saw.
It's important, like...
I was literally just checking.
You know, I was like,
oh, I appreciate that,
you.
Thank you.
Now I feel good, but everyone else is like,
okay.
Not in a good place. I was like, what are you going to do about it?
Oh, she's fine. She's just in a balled up in a little corner in that little bed up there.
Mm-hmm. And it's just, it's like, sorry, I skipped.
No,
oh,
okay.
My gosh,
Case. No, it's okay. No, it's okay. This is a safe space,
Kaiser.
It's okay.
Absolutely.
It's okay.
It's really emotional when it comes to this because it's like, are we going to have the courage to stand up for what's right?
Yeah.
When we don't have to.
Yeah. Yeah.
And it's like, it's painful to watch.
Yeah.
Honestly.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's really painful.
Yeah.
And when you're down, you, like, you hope that people kind of, like, reach out.
Yeah,
and tell you it's gonna be okay.
Yeah.
You can't watch an entire group of people go down. So it's sorry, I didn't.
No, I get you.
Sorry.
Oh,
that was...
Please don't ever be sorry. Especially for how you feel.
Yep.
I'm just not happy with, like, where we are as a society, honestly.
Yeah.
And I don't think a lot of people are. So I was thinking, I feel like God gives you opportunities to do something about it.
Yes.
Gives you a voice, gives you charisma, gives you courage. How you package it and what you decide to fight for is up to you.
Yeah.
And not everybody has that.
Mm-hmm.
And so, do you choose to use your looks and your abilities to, like, go get more Instagram followers?
Mm.
Or are you going to actually stand up for what's right?
Yeah.
Even though it's uncomfortable.
Yeah.
And those are, I think, defining moments.
I love it.
I couldn't take it anymore.
Mm.
To be honest. It's just, I got to a point, I was like, it's not okay.
Yeah.
It's not okay. You see people hurting, and you see people hurting each other.
Yeah.
And it's just, it's like, it's gotten so bad, it's like, you don't even know where it's coming from anymore.
Yep.
And silence is value.
Yeah.
It's loud, too. So those who decide to speak up and do something or say something, just to, even if it's a teaching moment of spreading awareness, that's not something to just bat an eye to, you know?
Oftentimes silence is complicit. I mean, you're being complicit in all of this. So I don't think the problem is, as you start to get more in a position where you can make a difference, you lose your courage. And it's the people who are still fighting or still, like, they don't have that voice yet. And they're like, if I only had that. And then you get there, and then people are listening, and you're like, but I might lose my job, people might not like the message, or they might accuse me of something, and then, like, they might unfollow me. Like, whatever it is that bothers you, that fear strikes, and then you choose not to move forward. And so I think that it's important that people stand together and just stand for what's right, and do it in a very sophisticated way, you know? Like, show your best.
Yeah.
You know, because, like, you have to be able to say, you know, like, and that was the thing that I tried to do the first time around.
Absolutely.
It's like, you always try to show our worst. I'm going to give you our best. And let me show you by example. So I don't have to get into any debates about the subject. And so, oftentimes, the problem really is, it's about a control of the narrative. And I look at what's happening about protests, and kneeling, and taking a knee, and Colin Kaepernick, and the national anthem, and all these things, and it's like, it's not about any of that.
Mm-hmm.
It's about, you're not allowing them to tell their story. And that's not okay. And so, that needs to stop.
Yeah.
And people shout because you never listened in the first place. So we got to get to a point where they can hear their whispers, and we can stay connected and stop making it about things that it's not. Because that means you were never listening in the first place.
Yeah. Wow, thank you for that.
Sorry,
that,
I don't know how we got into that, but...
That's important.
Extremely important.
That's important. 24 hours.
Yeah.
That's important.
I'm so glad he
Those
actually brought that up.
Those are conversations that need to be had. That's important. So thank you for that.
Of course.
Thank you
for
that.
I mean, it's just... Honestly, it's just coming from the heart.
Yeah, absolutely.
I really mean everything I said.
Yeah.
I think... We got. You gotta want for others what you want for yourself.
Yeah.
Yep.
So.
Yeah.
I hope we can get there. Like, any, it's just everything, like, even, like, this pandemic, like, get your shit together. You know, elected leaders, you were hired to stop squabbling and protect the people that you work for. Like,
yep.
So we can get back on track. Like,
yep.
Make people feel safe again.
Yep.
All of those things, you know, these are demands that the people should place.
Yep.
Stop getting sucked into these stupid, like, headlines that you can go and pretend like you read something, but all you're doing is just, like, regurgitating what you just heard 10 seconds ago.
Yep.
We're better than that.
Yep. Hmm. Yep.
We are so much better than it.
I mean, how beautiful is it that we can all sit together, like, people from...
Yep. That's exactly what I was just thinking.
All over.
Yeah.
All over the different nationalities, different backgrounds, different circumstances, and come in a place where we can have these conversations.
Yeah.
And it could be about nothing. It could be like, what did you have for breakfast today?
Mm-hmm.
And there's something incredible about that.
Yeah.
Because I don't know if I would have ever had the privilege of doing this.
Yep.
So...
It's always what I say, just, like, the chance to be able to, like, meet all of you and interact with all of you, like, just different walks of life and different experiences and different lineage and different, like, home life. It's humbling. It's informing. I think about it, and I just get, like, it's just amazing. It's absolutely incredible.
And it's important not to take it for granted.
Yep.
It's so important not to take it for granted.
Yeah.
I say we do a group hug tonight before NAMS tomorrow. I'm gonna call a house meeting and do it.
Just everyone? Just
the
basket?
Just call a house meeting.
It's one big group hug.
I would love that.
Let's do it.
We really should.
So, like, what's the occasion? Nothing.
Nothing.
Just life. Just diversity. Just.
Just love.
Love.
Just love. That's it. And that's so crazy. We've been programmed to think if I want to hug you, there's a problem or there's some type of motive behind it.
Yeah.
Just love. Just it.
This is so fucking wholesome. I love this shit.
Yeah.
Dude, they all think alike. I fucking love it.
I'm down. Let's do it.
Yeah, absolutely. Oh, I love
that.
That
was good.
Just before
Thank you for trusting us to be vulnerable, though.
I think it's important.
Thank you.
I mean, you know what that's about, right? You gotta put yourself out there and hope that it means something to the people that are on the receiving end.
Yeah.
But it's like, also, when it's like so, when the message itself, like, is hard to carry,
mm-hmm.
you can't help yourself.
Yep.
You get
mm-hmm.
emotional.
Mm-hmm.
It's too heavy.
Mm-hmm.
So... It is what it is.
Yeah. And who you talk to, you know, there's a big difference between being listened to and being heard, you know?
Boom.
There's
yeah.
such a big difference.
Yeah. Because many people will listen and it'll go
yep.
and write out.
Yep.
And then there's others that hear and it's like, okay, so now what can we do?
Yep.
Let's do something, you know?
Solution? Group hug.
Right.
It's a good start.
That is a good start.
Very solution oriented. With no time at all. Yeah. Yeah. Cool. Where do you live?
Long Island, New York.
You've always lived there.
Born, raised, and residing.
And are you still, are you with your family?
Yep. I live with my parents and my sisters.
That's amazing. You guys are all very close.
Yeah, extremely close. They're my world.
That's awesome.
It's like
and
my
it,
hub.
And then this whole, like, so you, I just watched the seasons. So you're deathly afraid of birds.
That freaking HOH room, they have, like, birds behind the headboard. What is that?
That
was
That's
for you.
Decor.
That was for you.
Who decorated that?
All right, we'll go back to this in a bit. I want to see if anything interesting is happening. Whoa, 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 wait, what the fuck? Oh, I thought there was more people. Sorry.
That's what we're grateful for.
Yeah.
What are you grateful for?
Being here, I guess, and my family's, like, all good back home.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
It's a wholesome night.
Like, I have too many feelings today. God, I'm so sorry. I do not want to bring you. I'm going to go in the room.
Go, do not. We
I'm
have
fine.
Tissues and everything.
Yeah.
Don't you dare.
Yeah.
You're fine. You do not burden us.
Yeah.
No.
I'm trying. I was good, but I don't like
it. It's an emotional day.
I wonder, she's got to do the whole probably diary room about her thing.